Hi, I'm presenting the research paper Decide Yourself or Delegate: User Preferences Regarding the Autonomy of Personal Privacy Assistance in IoT-Equipped Environments. I want to give a little shout-out to my co-authors that put so much work into this paper. So, let's dive into it. Some of you watch this recording on their smartphone or computer, very much like the person you see here. However, smart devices installed in our surroundings fundamentally change how we interact with computers. Further, as you can see, the devices can capture data about us in our very private spaces. It could be our homes or the home of a friend. And this results in privacy challenges. Personal privacy assistance, PPAs for short, were proposed as a way to give the users more control about their data in private IoT-equipped environments. The IoT device could send a request to the personal privacy assistant that could be on a smartphone that hosts the PPA. The PPA then knows the user preferences, for instance, by directly asking the user, and then communicates this to the IoT device. This, in a way, also reflects how cookie banners are currently implemented. I guess all of you know them. And when we started our PPA research, we wanted to avoid creating a solution where a user enters a room with many IoT devices, gets so many notifications that they get frustrated, and in the end feel so overwhelmed that they don't want to use the PPA anymore. So we looked for a different way of getting the user preferences as a way to realize the PPA without having to ask them over and over again. We found several ways to realize PPAs in the literature. One idea was you use default privacy settings that the user has to configure during installation. The second one were privacy profiles that represent user archetypes. And finally, of course, there is machine learning as a possible solution. Since default settings were very cumbersome and machine learning might be challenging for users to predict because users might not predict what is learned, we chose to investigate privacy profiles in our specific study. For this, we used the profiles proposed by Dupré et al. As a starting point. They consider the dimensions knowledge and motivation and propose 5 specific profiles. To investigate those in more depth, we conducted 3 pre-studies that I will present on the next slide. First, we investigate to which extent the profiles could present the preferences of IoT users. There, we found gaps, meaning that study participants were not represented by one of the 5 profiles. So, in our second step, we used established constructs from the literature based on different questionnaires to capture user properties to A, better describe the Dupré profiles, and also fill in the gaps. Based on that, we could propose a first set of questions to assign a user to a profile. In our third pre-study, we validated the questionnaire that we proposed by assigning the profiles to users and asking them about the profile fit. Here you see our proposed extension. However, we, and also the reviewers of our paper, didn't find the naming of the profiles ideal. So we also propose alternative profile titles using a more inclusive language and avoiding terms like lazy. Within the study, we never showed any titles to users. So now we had a set of the profiles and a way to assign them, and we wanted to investigate them in the connection to PPA autonomy. In the literature, we found 3 PPA types. A notification PPA that notifies the user about every request, very much like the one in the video that you saw earlier. The second one was a recommendation PPA that also notifies the users and recommends decisions based on past decisions or some other kind of algorithm. And finally, a fully autonomous PPA that acts without user input, just in the background. In an online study with 1,126 participants, we first assigned a profile to the participants. Then we showed them the 3 PPA types in general and asked them to rank them based on their preference and to also explain the ranking. Then each user was shown 18 scenarios and asked which PPA they prefer and whether they would share data in this respective scenario. One scenario looked like this. Imagine you are at environment and environment IoT devices request access to data. This request happens request times a day, and this means about number times per hour. The environment could either be the own home or another private household, like the home of a friend. The data could be biometric, we chose audio or video, data about consumer behavior or presence based on related work again. And to investigate scalability aspects, we varied the number of requests, as you can see here. In the remainder of the talk, I will present a few results. We have quite a lot, and of course, all of them are in the paper. So here's an overview of the PPA choice per profile for each scenario. I know it looks a bit confusing, so let's break that down a little bit and make it a bit easier. Now, only scenarios with a medium or high number of requests are highlighted. And we can see that most people would prefer an autonomous decision PPA in situations like this. When we now change the highlighting a bit and look at the individual profiles, those with a high knowledge prefer notification PPAs in scenarios with low requests. Those with low knowledge and motivation, of course, prefer autonomous ones, even in the ones with low requests. I found this like really interesting. And yeah, this already brings me to the end of my talks. This are getting like really short. So to sum up, users tend to prefer autonomous PPAs. The privacy profiles are a step towards that. There's more research needed to investigate what kind of decisions users prefer. And we also have some results on that on the paper, which is accessible through the QR code below. So thanks for your attention. If you have any question, here's my email address or drop me a message on Twitter or X. See you.